If your Galaxy S20 Ultra screen is cracked or just starting to turn green, replacing it yourself is an option and we can show you how. This video will guide you through replacing the display on your Galaxy S20 Ultra. For this repair, you will need an eye opener, a suction handle, a set of iFixit opening picks, a spudger, tweezers, a Phillips 00 screwdriver, and some high concentration isopropyl alcohol. We recommend over 90%. And for parts, you will need a replacement display, and if not already applied, some adhesive to hold the new display in place. You will also need adhesive for the back cover when closing up the phone. We also recommend using our magnetic mat so that you can keep track of screws and write down notes during your repair, and following the guide on iFixit.com. On the guide, you can read tips and tricks that will help you throughout the repair. Before you begin, make sure that your battery is drained to below 25%. This reduces the risk of fire if the battery is damaged during the repair. Warning: if your battery is swollen, take appropriate precautions and do not heat your phone. We'll leave a link with swollen battery instructions in the description below. Start by heating up an eye opener and place it on the bottom edge of the phone's back cover. Leave it there for about 2 minutes, then apply a suction handle on the spot you just heated up and pull it with a strong, steady force. This will create a gap between the cover and the frame for the next step. Warning: do not apply excessive force with the pick while cutting the adhesive during the next few steps, or you might crack the back cover glass. When you see the gap, grab an opening pick and insert the point into the gap so that the adhesive doesn't re-adhere. This may take more than one attempt due to tight tolerances. If so, apply more heat. Once you have your pick inserted, slide the pick back and forth along the bottom edge, making sure you slice through all the adhesive. Then leave a pick in the seam so that the adhesive doesn't reseal. Next, grab your eye opener again and heat the left edge of the back cover this time and insert a pick into the middle of the phone and slide it toward the bottom. When you are done cutting all the adhesive there, leave the pick at the bottom edge and grab another pick and slide it to the top edge. Now repeat the same process on the right edge. Once that is done, use your eye opener to heat the top edge and use your pick to slice through the adhesive there. When slicing around the corners at the top, be careful because the curved edge is very susceptible to cracking. Be very gentle. Once you have released all the adhesive, you can remove the back cover. Now go ahead and use your spudger to disconnect the wireless charging coil connector. Use a pair of tweezers to gently peel the wireless charging coil up and away from the phone. Next, grab your driver and remove the 5 Phillips screws securing the motherboard bracket. Then, with your tweezers, unclip and remove the bracket. With your spudger, disconnect the battery connector and then use your driver to remove 5 more Phillips screws securing the loudspeaker and the lower midframe. Insert your tweezers into the notch at the top left corner of the lower midframe and pry up to release the clips holding it in place. It should come right out. With your spudger, go ahead and disconnect the display cable on the motherboard. Warning: do not apply excessive force with the pick while cutting the adhesive during the next few steps, or you risk cracking the display. If your display is cracked, pause here and follow our guide on how to tape over a cracked phone screen, linked in the description below. Tape will keep the glass shards in place and provide an even surface for the suction handle. Next, grab your eye opener and begin heating the top edge of the display for about 2 minutes. Once it's nice and hot, apply a suction handle as close to the center of the top edge as possible. Start pulling on the suction handle with a strong and steady force until you see a gap. If you have any trouble, be sure to apply a hot eye opener again. When you see the gap, insert the point of an opening pick and then leave it there so the adhesive doesn't reseal. Get another pick and insert it into the same gap and slide it across the top left corner. Make sure you slice through the adhesive and then leave the pick in the corner. Now grab another pick and do the same towards the top right corner. Slide the center pick further into the top of the phone, making sure you cut all the adhesive. You can then remove the pick if you want, but we decided to leave it there to make sure the adhesive doesn't reseal. Get your hot eye opener again and start heating the right edge of the display for a bit, then insert the opening pick into the gap at the bottom of the right corner. Start sliding the pick down towards the bottom, cutting all the adhesive in your path, and leave the pick at the bottom right corner. Then insert a pick in the center to prevent the adhesive from sticking. Repeat this process on the left edge of the phone. With all that done, we are now going to grab some isopropyl alcohol and apply it behind the display through the bottom of the phone. This will release the clear adhesive under the screen. Tilt the phone around so that the alcohol spreads and loosens all the adhesive. If you left the pick in at the top center of the phone, remove it now and then grab your spudger and slowly insert the flat end under the screen and separate any remaining adhesive. With all that done, now you can remove the display. Before you install your new display, be sure to clean all the old adhesive and install new adhesive to your phone. This is important to hold the display in place and retain water and dust resistance. We have a video on how to do just that in the description. With your adhesive installed, bring over the new display and insert the display cable through the hole in the case. Then lay your display down, but don't remove the adhesive liner just yet. Connect the display cable and then connect the battery. Now is a good time to power up the phone and make sure your new display is working correctly. If it is, go ahead and power off your phone first, then disconnect the battery and display cables. Remove your display and then remove the adhesive lining to expose the glue. Now you can install your display again, then flip the phone over and connect the display cable. Now go ahead and reinstall the loudspeaker and screw it back into place. You can now safely reconnect the battery. Next, lay the motherboard bracket back into place and reinstall the screws securing it to the phone. Grab your wireless charging coil and connect it first so that it is properly aligned, and then you can press it down into place. Before you close up your phone, be sure to apply new adhesive to your back cover. We have a video that walks you through this process, linked in the description below. Lay the back cover onto your phone and press it firmly in place. Then be sure to set some weight, like a book or a toolkit, flat on the top of the phone for at least 30 minutes so that the adhesive seals tight.